with all of the loss and all of the devastation that we faced with COVID, there are some important lessons that we need to learn and extract from this experience.
What we really have started to do is listen instead of talking and really try to say, what are the reasons why, if we have a recommended treatment in any area or a vaccine, let's talk about the reasons why you don't think this is a good idea. Then we provide the information that meets that patient's needs.
Community health really took on a new meaning. I think we thought about communities and I think we talked about communities as partners, but I think during the pandemic, we became very, very, very true partners with the communities. We were going out to find the needy and the vulnerable patients to make sure that we could serve them as well. And I mean, people are smart and people have thought a lot about this. And I think having really meaningful conversations with people, helping them understand what's available for them and the importance of these things, and then helping them go through the process of deciding what's right for them, I think a very valuable lesson.
The infrastructure that is able to identify high-risk candidates early enough and have a mechanism that easily connects them to sources of supply and treatment is also suboptimal and definitely inadequate. And so this is teaching us a lot that we need to learn about how the infrastructure of how healthcare is delivered, the relationship between public health interventions and clinical care delivery, the relationship between marketing and advertising of important public health initiatives and connecting that with marketing and advertising of clinical therapeutic interventions. All of these are elements that we now need to bring together. We need to be attentive and focused on these issues. While we are in the middle of the pandemic, it's very challenging to pull this off, but we can do it and we are doing it. And what we now need to be is aware of how we connect different systems like public health engagement with clinical care systems in a much more integrated, data-driven, and communicative way so that we will be working holistically to address the needs of individuals and communities and not operating what we do in the traditional silos that have so far proven to be ineffective.
The communication and the collaboration has been phenomenal, and the sharing of mission and vision has been really phenomenal. This model is something that worked. It reached people who we weren't reaching otherwise.
The collaborating with the physicians caring for these patients is key. Really importantly, frequent updates about what we're seeing, both in terms of some of the data or conclusions that we were drawing, sharing that was really important.
I think what you saw here was a community that banded together at every level to fight the COVID-19 crisis. And this was new for everybody. But I think ultimately what you saw was a commitment to serve the patients in our community. We knew that everyone had a role to play. Everybody's role was different. And the roles evolved from March of 2020 to, May of 2021. I think communication can't be underscored enough